Hello wonderful person, this is Anton, and today we're going to be talking about new dangers we've discovered when it comes to living in outer space, and more specifically, living in zero-g conditions. Let's talk a little bit more about what NASA recently discovered, and welcome to What the Math. So in the last few years, we've discovered quite a lot of things about living on the International Space Station, and most of it is actually not so good. Basically, it's not really good news. We've already discovered there are some major physiological changes that humans undergo by living so long on the ISS, or basically in zero-g conditions, and some of these changes are a little bit scary. One of these more scary discoveries from last year, for example, suggested that inside our bodies, if we were to stay in space for a very long time, the heart would actually start pumping blood in the opposite direction, which can result in serious problems in our bodies, including, of course, losing consciousness and basically possibly even passing out or worse. And we've also discovered some major changes in our genes that happen over time, a lot of which were observed during the so-called NASA's twin study, where these two wonderful people were used as, I guess you would call them, lab rats. Anyway, so we've discovered a lot of different things. And one of the bigger discoveries from the last few years is actually something related to the astronauts' vision. For some reason, most, if not all of the astronauts experience serious vision problems during their time in space. And in some cases, it even continues when they return to Earth. In other words, something may happen to human eyes, or something may happen to the part of the brain that's responsible for vision that causes these unusual health conditions that we actually refer to as SANS, which stands for Spaceflight Associated Neuroocular Syndrome. In general, SANS seems to be different for different astronauts. Sometimes it's just blurry vision, other times it's headaches, and sometimes it's something even worse but related to vision. And so trying to investigate what's happening here and obviously discovering the true reasons has always been sort of the priority for various NASA studies. And so by collecting data from 11 different astronauts, 10 men and 1 woman, over the past few years, the scientists behind this study may have finally been able to find the reason for why SANS happened. But they don't really have a solution to it just yet. So let's find out what they discovered. First of all, most of these astronauts stayed on the ISS for roughly around 170 days in total, so a pretty long time. And prior to being launched to the ISS, all of these astronauts have undergone a very thorough analysis, including the brain MRI testing, which allowed these scientists to have something to compare their brains to once they came back. Several more MRIs were done at several different periods, including 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, and so on. And the main idea was to really investigate what's happening with the astronaut's brain as they spend such a long time in essentially microgravity, and also in relatively hostile conditions when it comes to, I guess, radiation as well. And the main hypothesis here was that something inside the brain, specifically the pressure inside the brain, was changing to cause these unusual effects. And so by analyzing human brain and by analyzing the brains of these astronauts, they were able to discover that it is indeed true. The brain size seems to actually change and increase by roughly around 2%, which is actually best demonstrated in this little animation they created using the brains before and the brains after. Here you can kind of see the actual volume of the brain slowly increasing. You can kind of see it again right here, it's slowly expanding this part of the brain. Now this is actually really important because the part that's being increased in size is actually related to something known as pituitary gland and also so-called cerebrospinal fluid and white matter, all of which increase by roughly around 2%. So first of all, the pituitary gland that you see right here, it's actually responsible for various hormones that are secreted by our body. These hormones often regulate things like growth, blood pressure, they also regulate sexual activity, water and salt concentration, metabolism, and actually quite a lot of other things. So the changes in this gland could produce quite a lot of various conditions, and some of them unfortunately could be detrimental to human health. White matter, on the other hand, is also responsible for, well, technically learning. Now, we don't really know how the increase in white matter affected these astronauts, but it definitely had some sort of effect. We don't know if it's positive or negative just yet, we just know that the white matter volume changed by about 2% as well. And as this video shows, also the volume of the so-called ventricles, basically the empty space inside the brain, where a lot of various cerebrospinal fluid is located, have also increased in size. And what's kind of scary is that these changes were permanent, more or less, and they were also kind of occurring even after the astronauts returned to Earth. So in other words, these are more or less permanent changes to their bodies, and we don't really know if they'll ever disappear. But their study also may have found the answer to the so-called SANS, the vision problems. So because the changes in pituitary gland and also just the general changes in the brain were physical, it actually increased the pressure inside the brain. And as you can see from this particular illustration, these changes in pressure here started to put more pressure on this area, which is actually responsible for vision in humans. So the increase in pressure very likely caused these changes in vision and basically caused all of these disorders we're observing when it comes to visual acuity in humans in space. The other explanation is that maybe the pituitary gland itself is actually also pressing against the so-called optic nerve, which does pass really close to the pituitary gland, and by increasing in size, that area sort of squeezes the optic nerve, causing other visual disorders as well. So in other words, there could be several different effects that are caused by all of this expansion inside the brain. Some of them might be related to brain, and some of them might be related to the actual nerves. But unfortunately, this is kind of troublesome, because if an astronaut starts experiencing vision problems on the mission, like for example, if we're going to Mars and the mission lasts for about 200 days in zero-G conditions, this might create a problem. If the astronaut is unable to see very well and starts experiencing blurry vision, for example, or is completely unable to see what's in front of their face essentially, this will make the mission to Mars or actual mission to anywhere extremely difficult. And since as humans, vision for us is the primary sensory apparatus, basically without vision, most of us really have trouble functioning, this means that any kind of a mission, prolonged mission in zero-G conditions, might need a lot of preparation and possibly a lot of different medicine and drugs. And because this study suggests that the vision will not improve even after landing on Mars where there is some gravity, this of course makes all of this a little bit more complicated. Now, luckily, NASA has been pretty busy at trying to develop solutions to this SANS problem, and one of them is a type of glasses that NASA astronauts can actually wear to try to improve their vision in space. Although they don't look as cool as the ones I just showed you, they look kind of like this. As a matter of fact, an astronaut wearing them does look pretty bad. But it's not always about the looks, it's about looking, right? It's about seeing things. And then there are also certain medications that can be prescribed to astronauts in space to try to improve their vision that way by also decreasing the actual pressure inside their eyes. This is a similar medication that's often used for glaucoma. But despite all of this, it's still kind of early to tell how safe it is for us to actually travel in space for such long periods of time and to try to land on other planets essentially. It will take a lot more experiments on the ISS to try to establish these safety procedures and to try to understand how exactly our bodies change, which seems to be quite a lot by the way, once we spend a long period of time living in zero-G conditions. But luckily, the ISS is going to be around for at least a few more years, and during that time we'll hopefully be able to discover what is it that we need for us to actually go ahead and start traveling around space in relatively safe conditions. For now though, that's unfortunately all we know about this. Check out the study I mentioned in the description below, subscribe if you still haven't, share this with someone who loves learning about space and sciences, and consider supporting this channel on Patreon, because it does help me quite a lot. You can also support this channel by buying the Wonderful Person t-shirt that you can find in the description below. In either way though, come back tomorrow to learn something else. I'll see you tomorrow, space out, and as always, bye bye. And honestly, I would really love to get a copy of those special glasses, because that would make me look even geekier than I already do. If you know where I can get a copy, or if you work for NASA and can send me a copy, that would be absolutely awesome. Thank you. Bye-bye.